请大家同心默祷。Let us all have a silent prayer. Sila doa dalam hati. Hallelujah, Amen. 在我们还没有开始我们的会前诗颂以前，我们一起来做个祷告。Sebelum kita memulakan sesi kidung, marilah kita bersama-sama bersujud berdoa. Before we begin our hymnal session, let us all kneel down to pray.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hallelujah. 奉主耶稣圣名开始我们的会前诗颂。In the name of Lord Jesus, we begin our hymn session. Dalam nama Tuhan Yesus, kita memulakan sesi kidung. 首先，我们来唱一首诗歌来赞美我们的主耶稣。Let us all sing hymn 163. Silang yang kidung 163. 唱诗163首。 们继续唱诗，诗歌231首。Continue to sing hymn, hymn number 231. Silang yang kidung, seterusnya 231.再唱下一首诗歌244首 Continue to sing hymn 244 Yang iki dong seterusnya 244
是上帝才能被带出
再唱下一首诗歌，第341首。Continue to sing him 341. Silang yang kidong seterusnya 341.感谢主，我们会前诗送到此。Thank God our hymn session ends here. 祝各位表都欢喜喜激动，三拜的心里，哈利路亚。
哎，哈利路亚！各位兄弟姐妹，大家晚上平安。
哈利路亚 ，Dear brothers and sisters, peace be with you。
我们大家预备一颗清洁的心，来继续敬拜我们天上的真神耶稣基督。
Let's all prepare a pure heart to worship our true God in heaven, the Lord Jesus Christ。
同心默祷。
Say a silent prayer。
Amen。奉主耶稣圣名开始晚上的聚会。
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we begin our evening service.
大家起立唱赞美诗106首。
You will rise to sing hymn number 106.
我是耶稣门徒。
Jesus, blessed Savior.
I will stay
感谢主耶稣拣选我们成为他的门徒。
We thank the Lord Jesus for choosing us to be His disciples.
门徒不只是跟从主。
A disciple doesn't only follow Christ.
门徒更是一个学习主的人，学习主的人。
A disciple is one who learns and emulates from the Lord.
讲清楚，门徒就是学生学老师的。
A disciple is a student who emulates after the teacher.
我是耶稣的门徒，我是耶稣的学生。
The disciple of the Lord Jesus, I am his student.
那么你跟从，我们跟从也是要学什么呢？
What do we learn from him?
我们来一起来祷告。
Let's now pray.
奉主耶稣圣名祷告，哈利路亚！感谢赞美主耶稣，哈利路亚。感谢主耶稣，阿门。哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名正道。
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
靠着圣灵的帮助。
By the help of the Holy Spirit.
我们继续来分享，来学习主耶稣十字架道路的十个步。
We continue to share and learn from the topic the Lord Jesus Christ. On the way of the Lord Jesus Christ, what are these 10 don'ts?
那还记得上一次我们分享过的五个不吗？
Do you remember the last session from which we shared on 5 don'ts?
第一个不就是不骑战嘛。
The first don't, do not ride on battle horses.
在十字架这条道路上不骑战。
On the way of this cross, we do not ride on battle horses.
第二个不就是不求己意，不求自己的意思。
The second don't, do not seek our own will.
完全的顺服天父的旨意。
We completely obey the will of the Father in heaven.
人总是有很多自己的意见。
People often have our own opinions.
这是在十字架上的第二个不里面我们要认真学习的。
And this is something that we have to learn appropriately from the second don't on the way of the cross.
那第三个不就是不动刀兵。
The third don't, do not draw your sword.
虽然说我们信的主明白道理，我们还是充满着血气，我们有时也会动怒，甚至会动刀兵。
Even as we have believed in Christ and we are still very fleshly, and sometimes we lose our temper, we draw our swords and our spears.
但是主耶稣教导我们，勉励我们，也提醒我们说。不要动刀兵。
But the Lord Jesus taught us this way that we do not draw our swords and spears.
十字架道路是第四个不是什么呢？
What's the fourth don't on the way of the cross?
第四个不就是不从十字架上下来。
Do not come down from the cross.
这是主耶稣受到挑战、受到讥笑、受到羞辱的时候。
That's when the Lord Jesus was being challenged, being mocked at, and also being humiliated.
你有本事你就下来啊。
If you are so great, come down from the cross.
你讲到你这么厉害，讲到你是神，讲到你怎么样怎么样，死人复活，瞎眼看见，你下来啊，你救你自己啊，你讲什么呀？
You claim that you are God, you are so great, you saved the blind, and you healed the blind, and also saved the who are resurrected the dead. Why don't you come down from the cross and save yourself?
但是在十字架这条道路上受到纵使受到更大的羞辱跟讥笑，仍然不从十字架上下。
Although he was being challenged with a lot of humiliation and mockery, and he did not come down from the cross.
第五个
，the fifth don't.
第五个就是不借麻醉药麻醉来让自己减轻痛苦。
Do not administer the anesthesia to reduce your pain.
圣经记载，有人把醋让耶稣尝，耶稣尝了一下，原来是醋来的，他就不肯喝了，他就不肯。他就不肯再喝了。
In the Bible, that the Lord Jesus was given this myrrh to drink, but he did not drink from it because it was a form of wine to or a form of anesthesia.
因为这个醋有掺这个麻醉的有麻醉的成分在里面。
Because this wine or this mixture has been mixed with anesthesia.
主耶稣真真实实的去面对去承受十字架的所有痛苦，不逃避，不减轻。
And the Lord Jesus Christ, in his fullest and authentic self, he bore the sufferings and the pain of the cross without running away.
所以这叫做不借麻醉让自己减轻痛苦。
That's what we mean by do not administer anesthesia to reduce your suffering.
今天我们继续来学习十架道路上的第六个步。
And today we continue to study on the sixth don't on the way of the cross.
第六个步就是不离去真神。
We do not forsake the Lord Jesus, the true God.
我们有人离开真神吗？
Has anyone among us who have left the true God?
你会离开真神吗？
Will you forsake the true God?
十字架上的第六个不就是不离去神？
The sixth don't on the way of the cross is we do not forsake the true God.
请看马可福音书十五章。
We turn to the Gospel, Mark chapter 15.
三十四节。
Verse 34.
三十四节这里说，生出的时候，耶稣大声喊着说，以罗以，以罗以，拉玛瑟巴各大尼，翻出来就是我的神，我的神啊，为什么离弃我？我们在这里看到主耶稣在呼喊神啊，为什么离开我？
Here we see Jesus crying out with a loud voice, Why, O God, have you left, have you forsaken me?
有人读了这段圣经，就讥笑我们基督教的真神，基督讥笑我们的神。
Some people, after reading this passage, they mocked at the true God of Christianity.
他们说，主耶稣在最痛苦的时候，最需要神的时候，神却这个时候离开他。
They mocked in this way, saying that when the Lord Jesus Christ was suffering in the greatest suffering, the Lord God left him.
所以主耶稣在十字架上发出痛苦的呻吟，甚至发出这种抗议啊！神，你为什么离弃我？我最需要你的时候，我最痛苦的时候，你为什么离弃我？他们说这是一种抗议，向神抗议。
And it was as though, as they claimed, the Lord Jesus was crying out loud with a loud voice of suffering and pain, as well as protest against the true God.
你认为呢？
What do you think?
你会不会也认为像这些人这样，认为我们的神，哦，没有帮忙，在痛苦的时候离开呢？离开我们，离开耶稣呢
？Do you reckon that as your God who has departed or who has forsaken us in our worst kind of suffering?
你认为耶稣是在抗议吗
？Did the Lord Jesus protest?
啊，不然不是的话，你怎么解释呢
？Otherwise, how would you explain this verse?
啊，说这样话的人，完全根本不了解真神。
People who said, who utter these words means that they do not know the true God.
也不了解主耶稣。
They do not understand Jesus.
更不了解十字架救赎的道。
They do not understand the teaching of the salvation, the teaching of salvation on the cross.
为什么这些讥笑的人哦，他不看另一节圣经的记载呢
？Why wouldn't these people who are mocking at this, refer to another passage?
他不看整个十字架的过程呢？
Why didn't these people refer to the entire process of the salvation grace on the cross?
请看路加福音书二十三章。
Return to the gospel, Luke chapter 23.
路加福音书二十三章。
Luke chapter 23.
四十四到四十七节。
Verse 44 to 47.
好，请念。
Verse 44 to 47, and being in agony, he prayed more earnestly. Then his sweat became like great drops of blood falling to the ground. When he rose up from prayer and had come to his disciples, he found them sleeping from sorrow. Then he said to them, Why do you sleep? Rise and pray, lest you enter into temptation. 47, and while he was speaking, behold, a multitude who was called Judas, one of the 12, went before them and drew near to Jesus to kiss him.
这里记载什么？
What is recorded here?
记在主耶稣要断气之前，大声的喊着说：“父啊，我将我的灵魂交托在你的手了。”
Here it is mentioned in chapter 23 that, O Lord, I have entrusted into your hands my spirit.
这说明什么
？And what does it tell us?
这里清楚的说明主耶稣对天父真神的信任。
Here it tells us the complete faith and trust the Lord Jesus had in God.
他将自己的灵魂交托在真神的手里，天父的手里。
That in verse 46, saying that he has entrusted his spirit into the hands of the Father in heaven.
哦，所以主耶稣说：“父啊，我将灵魂交在你手上。”主耶稣对天父是非常的信任，没有怀疑，根本没有抗议，也不是没有抗议。
What here shows is that the Lord Jesus had complete trust in the Lord Jesus without any protest.
嗯，为什么那些讥笑人不看到这一点
？Why didn't people who mocked at Jesus look at this passage?
神离开耶稣是因为罪。
When the Lord God departed from Jesus, it was because of the sins that.
而且离开是暂时离开，不是永远的离开。
And that departure from him was only momentary.
如果你若知道耶稣此时身上的罪有多重。身上的罪有多可怕，你就不敢再讥笑耶稣。
If you realized how great the sin that the Lord Jesus Christ was bearing on the cross, you wouldn't complain that the Lord God left.
你就不敢再讥笑天父真神。
You would not be mocking at the true God in heaven.
神当然要离开他呀。
The Father in heaven had to forsake him.
你知道现在耶稣当时钉十字架他的罪有多重，你知道吗
？Can you comprehend how intense and how great was the sin the Lord Jesus was bearing?
你说得出来吗？
Can you even explain?
我们一个人的罪从小到大、哦、到年老我们犯了多少罪我们做了多少骄傲的事我们做了多少、哦、这种得罪神的事情
All the sins, all the transgressions we have committed from young and to our old age How much sins have you committed?
再多也只是你一个人的罪啊对不对
You can only comprehend your own sins
那已经很够重了
That was already heavy enough
可是主耶稣这时身上的罪、哦、是全世界人的罪都担在他身上你听好、哦、
But in this moment when the Lord Jesus was on the cross He was bearing the sins of all the people in the world
因为这是圣经记住了所有人的罪都担在耶稣身上那圣经说都归在耶稣的身上算在耶稣的身上呀
As recorded in the Bible that all iniquities and sins of the world have been borne on Jesus
一个人的罪都让神不能够跟我们在一起何况 全世界人 都在主耶稣身上你叫神怎么样跟他在一起、啊、
One person's sins alone were able to already separate God from man and how do you imagine the whole world their sins have been put on Jesus
所以我说那些讥笑神的人说神离开耶稣的人如果你真的明白耶稣现在身上的罪有多重，你不单只不会讥笑，你会感动，你会感动。
If I'm questioning all these people who are mocking Jesus at this moment, and that the true God left him, and if you understand the context of this, you will not be mocking, but you will be moved.
你不单只不会再讥笑神为什么离开主，你甚至会感恩，甚至会报恩。
Not only will you stop mocking, you will also repay this debt or this grace of God.
其实主耶稣在这时候的呼喊不是向神控诉，绝对不是。
At this moment when the Lord Jesus was crying out loud, it was not out of protest.
而是在向我们呼喊。
He was crying out to us.
向我们呼喊什么？
What is he crying out to us for?
向我们呼喊哦，一个被神离去的人是多么的可怜，是多么的可怕。
This cry towards us is for us to understand that when one has been left or forsaken by God, how terrifying would that be?
主耶稣就在十字架，神离去他的这段时间，向我们呼喊出来，一个被神离去的人是多么的痛苦，是要告诉我们啊。
In this moment,
是要让我们知道，让我们去明白啊。
This moment when the Lord God in heaven departed or forsook Jesus, and the Lord Jesus was crying out loud so that we are able to understand and feel what it felt like when God left us.
这才是主耶稣呼喊啊。神啊，为什么离开我的真正用意，真正的意义。
And that's the true meaning behind why the Lord Jesus cried out.
可是很可惜，很多人不明白主耶稣，误解了主耶稣。
Very pitifully, many people misunderstood this.
所以啊，不论我们遭遇到多么大的痛苦，或者是多么大的试探，都坚决不离弃真神。
Regardless of how great the temptations or sufferings that we face, we must be resolute, do not depart from.
虽然神暂时的离开耶稣，但是耶稣没有离开神啊。耶稣坚决的到死到断气都没有离开神啊，对不对？
Although here God forsook Jesus, but Jesus was resolved not to leave God.
不单只没有离去神，还将灵魂交在神的身上，神的手上。
Not only did Jesus not leave God, he also entrusted his whole spirit into the hands of God.
这就是十字架道路的第六个步，不离去神。虽然神离开他，他都不离去神。
That's the sixth don't on the way of the cross, that although the Lord God forsook him, he did not forsake God.
但很可惜，也很心痛。
What is very pitiful and very heartbreaking.
今天看到不少的人，不少的信徒已经离去了真神。
We can see that so many of us among us have already forsaken God.
离去了真神的救赎。
They've forsaken the salvation grace of God.
离去了真神的恩典。
Forsaken the graces of God.
离去了真神的爱。
Forsaken the love of God.
有一些虽然 人没有离去，心里早已经离开了，已经离开神了。
Some of us, although they have not forsaken or left physically, their hearts have already.
这是我们今天觉得很心痛也很可惜的事情。
That is something that is heartbreaking to us.
但你在这里看到，在这里你看到什么？
But what do you see here?
在十字架上。
On the cross.
虽然神离开了耶稣。
Although the Lord God forsook Jesus.
但耶稣不离去神。
But Jesus did not forsake God.
我们继续看十架道路的第七个步。
We continue to study on the seventh don't on the way of the cross.
第七个步就是不为自己来伸冤。
The seventh don't, do not avenge for yourself.
我们有时总会受很多的冤屈，很多冤枉的事情。
Sometimes we are under a lot of grudges and we have been blamed and slandered.
当然内心很痛苦。
And we suffer a lot.
也被人家误会，被人家攻击，被人家辱骂。
We have been misunderstood, we have been attacked, and we have been scolded.
但是你是清白的，你是被冤枉的。
But you are only innocent.
所以许多人，不少的人就到处去诉苦，到处去解释。
So many people attempt all their best to explain and to be innocent.
结果有时反而得不到人家的谅解，反而人家更轻视你，更不理睬你。
And as an outcome, sometimes people don't even understand you, or people will even despise you.
这样让自己的痛苦就更深，让自己的冤屈就更增加更大的冤屈。
As a result, that even added on more suffering on you.
但十字架的第七个步告诉我们。
But the seventh don't of the cross tells us.
我们要学习不为自己伸冤。
That we must learn not to avenge for ourselves.
是，我们是冤枉的。但是不要为自己伸冤。
Yes, you are innocent, but do not avenge for yourself.
这是主耶稣给我们留下的榜样。
That's an example set by the Lord Jesus for us.
我们看马太福音书二十七章。
We turn to the Gospel of Matthew chapter 27.
马太福音书二十七章。
Matthew chapter 27.
十二节到十四节。
Verse 12 to verse 14. Verse 12.And while he was being accused by the chief priests and the elders, he answered nothing. Then Pilate said to him, Do you not hear how many things that testify against you? 14, he answered him not one word, so that the governor marveled greatly.
这里记载，祭司长跟长老控告耶稣的时候，主耶稣一句话都不回答。
And now the chief priests and the elders accused Jesus, and Jesus answered nothing.
连比拉多审判主耶稣的那个巡抚比拉多都觉得很奇怪，他们告你这么多事情，你为什么不作声啊？你为什么不回答呀？不回应他们啊
？Even the judge or the governor Pilate had asked him that now that they are testifying against you, why are you not saying anything?
还是比拉多说，还是你根本没有听见他们在告你什么，你根本不懂。
And in his words, do you not hear how many things they are testifying against you?
十四节，主耶稣仍然不回答，连一句话也不说。
Jesus answered him not even one word.
难道主耶稣真的听不懂吗？没有听到他们的控告吗？没有听到他们的假见证吗？
Did the Lord Jesus Christ really not hear their accusations and false testimonies?
如果他们的是假的，那你就解释啊，你就讲啊，他们是假的呀，你就起来辩护啊，辩论啊。
If it was all false accusations, and you should speak up and you should tell them.
这个是巡抚比拉多的意思，那你就辩论吧，你就跟他们辩论吧。
What Pilate meant to say that you ought to debate against them.
但是耶稣连一句话都不说。
But the Lord Jesus answered not a word.
比拉多也觉得很奇怪，这件事非常奇怪。
And Pilate found it really strange.
哦，主耶稣在六次的审判当中，其实都有回答的，主耶稣都有说话。
In fact, throughout the six trials that the Lord Jesus stood, he did have given answers.
还记得吗？传道曾经讲过这个主题，主耶稣六次七次受审，有没有？
Do you remember the topic that I shared on the seven trials that Jesus stood?
六次是受人的审判，第七次，最后一次是受神的审判，神审判他。
Jesus stood six trials before man, and Jesus stood the seventh trial before God.
因为耶稣有罪啊，担当我们人的罪，他身上有罪。
Because Jesus had to bear the sins of all mankind.
有罪一定要被神公义的审判呢、啊，所以最后一次是被神审判，主耶稣是被神审判。
And because of sins, eventually the Lord Jesus had to be judged by the Lord God because of his sins.
那六次的审判当中，好多次主耶稣都有讲话的，不是完全没有讲话的。
In these six trials that he stood before man, he did speak.
但是直到最后这一次的时候呢，在上庭哈，在上这个比拉多这里受审的时候呢，主耶稣这时候连一句话都不说了。
But in this last trial where he stood to Pilate, he did not utter a word.
十字架的道路第七个步就是不为自己辩护。
On the way of the cross, the seventh don't is do not avenge for yourselves.
你知道为什么吗？
Do you know why?
因为要讲的我已经讲了。
Because I have spoken what I need to speak.
要回答的我也已经回答了他们了。
I have answered what I have been asked.
你不信你看十一节啊。
Look at verse 11.
耶稣站在巡抚面前，巡抚问他说：“你是犹太人的王吗？”耶稣说：“你说的乎，你说的是。”那个就是回答了。
The governor
那就是承认我就是王啊。
Asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus said, "Yes, it is as you say." And
我的意思是，我的意思，耶稣的意思是，我要讲的都已经讲了，要回答都已经回答了，可是你们又也不信啊，我回答了又怎样？你们也不听啊。
I'm trying to say that I've already spoken my answer as you have asked, and yet you do not listen.
所以到最后呢，不要再说了，一句话都不用说，也不用再辩护了。
And subsequently, I shall not utter any more because I will not debate for myself.
因为他们根本不想，不是要来听你讲话，要听你解释的。他们根本不是要听你解释的。
Because they're not here to listen to your explanation at all.
所以让我们学习到哦，该说话的时候。一句都不漏的说，一句不漏的说。
And here from here we can learn that when you ought to speak, you shall speak.
不该说的时候，一句话也不说。
And when you ought not to speak, you shall not speak.
我们应当要学会这个说话的情形。
And this is something we can learn from the way of speaking.
该说的时候，一句不漏的说。
When you ought to speak,
说得清清楚楚。
You speak up clearly.
不该说的时候呢，一句也不用说。
When you ought not speak, you do not speak.
有一句话这样说。
There's a saying.
那些明白你的人
，people，
你不需要解释。
People who will understand you do not need your explanation.
因为他们了解你的人。
Because they already understand.
那不明白你的人，你解释也没有用。
And people who will not understand you, they will not understand even though you explain.
那些恨你的人。更加不会听你解释。
People who hate you will not even bother to listen to your explanation.
所以呢，就不必多说了。
And therefore, there's no need to speak.
交托给主。
And trust that to God.
安静的等候主耶稣公义的审判的到来。
And quietly wait for the Lord Jesus and his righteous judgment.
因为我们坚信神是公义的，一定会替我们伸冤的。
Because we believe truly that the Lord God is righteous and just, he will avenge for us.
圣经里面清清楚楚记录的，神是公义的神，一定会替我们伸冤的。
That is as recorded in the Bible that the Lord God is just and righteous, he will avenge for us.
先看罗马书十二章。
Return to Romans chapter 12.
所以保罗这样勉励我们。
Therefore, Paul encouraged us.
罗马书十二章十九节。
Romans chapter 12, verse 19.
亲爱的弟兄啊，不要为自己伸冤。
Brethren, do not avenge yourselves.
宁可让步，听凭主怒。
But rather give place to wrath.
因为经上记着说，伸冤在我，我必报应。
For it is written, vengeance is mine, I will repay.
若有不公平的事，有伸冤的事，我们宁可让步，宁愿吃亏，宁愿自己受伤，没有关系。
If there is unfairness or injustice, we give in. We will.
安静的把这件事交托给主，听凭主怒。主耶稣是欢喜我们，还是生气我们？我们就看主耶稣，我们就是交托给主。
Quietly and trust to God and give place to wrath.
如果我做的真的是错的，主耶稣会对我发怒的。他不单止不帮我伸冤，他还会管教我，会打我的。
If indeed what I've done was wrong, the Lord Jesus will be chastising me.
如果我真的是受冤屈的、受陷害的，主耶稣会对那些人发怒的，主耶稣会对付他们的。
But if I was really wrongly accused, the Lord Jesus will avenge for me and will chastise.
这叫做听凭主怒啊。
And that's what it means to give place to wrath.
我们不要再发怒，我们不要再发脾气，再喊再叫，都不用呀。
There's no need for us to be angry, to be full of wrath, and to scream and shout.
这时候要做的，我们宁愿吃亏，宁愿让步，宁愿安静，宁愿忍耐下来啊。
At this time, you ought to just give in, and you would rather lose out.
十字架道路上的第七个步就是不为自己伸冤。
The seventh don't on the way of the cross is do not avenge for yourselves.
启示录告诉我们，主耶稣一定会替我们伸冤的。
The book of Revelation tells us that the Lord Jesus will indeed avenge.
所以在启示录第六章里面有一个伸冤的意象。
Revelation chapter 6 tells us of a vision about avenging.
我们叫喊冤的意象啊，喊冤的祭坛。
There's the altar of the altar of crying out in vengeance.
先看启示录第六章。
We look at Revelation chapter 6,
九到十一节。
Verse 9 to verse 11.
揭开第五印的时候，我看见在祭坛底下有为神的道，并为作见证被杀之人的灵魂，大声喊着说：“圣洁真实的主啊，你不审判住在地上的人，给我们伸流血的冤吗？要到几时呢？”十一节。
Verse 11.
于是有百一赐给他们个人，又有话对他们说：“还要安息片时，等着一同做仆人的和他们的弟兄，也向他们被杀满足的数目。”这第五印的时候看到开起来呢，是一个喊冤的祭坛，喊冤的祭坛。
When this fifth seal was being opened, you can see this altar where the souls have been crying out for vengeance.
那些为主耶稣、为福音、为教会、为神的道被逼迫而死的，被受冤屈、被辱骂、被羞辱而死的，他们在这里喊冤，叫耶稣替他们伸冤，还他们一个清白。
These people and the saints who have been suffering and persecuted as well as slain for the sake of the gospel, now they're crying out to the Lord God to avenge for them.
这种喊冤也是一个公义的行为。
Even this cries of crying out for vengeance.
不是说我们要去对付那些害我们的人，而是说那些行恶的人一定要受到报应，一定要为他们所做的恶付出代价，这叫做公义。这样才是公义啊。
This is not an intent to sabotage the enemies or to pay vengeance, but this is out of righteousness that they have to do this.
主耶稣安慰他们。
The Lord Jesus comforted them.
再忍耐一下。
Rest a little longer.
为什么呢？
Why so?
因为还有兄弟姐妹，还有许多忠心的仆人还没有被杀，他们一样被逼迫。
Because
等他们也逼迫被杀了，满了时候到了，我就伸冤了。
There are other fellow faithful servants and brethren who are yet to be killed, and as soon as it was completed, God will avenge for us.
原来你在这里你看到什么？
What do you see here?
在这里看到原来不是你一个人受冤屈，还有很多啊。
You are not.
还有很多人受冤屈的在这里喊冤啊，不是你一个人啊。
You are not the only one suffering under all these sufferings, and there are many more.
那还有那些还没有被杀的，还在继续在受冤屈的。还有啊，还跟着来啊，还跟 还有很多跟做来呀。
And even after you, there are a lot more fellow servants and brethren who are about to be suffering.
这是神主耶稣透过启示录告诉我们，他一定会替我们伸冤的。
And that's what the Lord Jesus have revealed to us that He will surely avenge for us.
那传道一直这样强调是什么意思呢
？Why am I trying to stress to you so much？
意思就是你不要自己去伸冤啦。
I'm trying to stress to you that you do not avenge for yourself.
是很痛苦，没有错，是很痛苦。
Indeed, you are suffering a lot now.
安静下来。
But calm yourself down.
交托给主。
And trust that to God.
好，我们继续看十字架道路上的第八个步。
We continue to look at the eight don't on the way of the cross.
第八个不是什么呢
？What is this eight don't?
就是不入迷惑，不进入迷惑里去。
Do not enter into temptation.
请看这个马太福音书二十六章。
Return to Gospel Matthew chapter 26.
马太福音书二十六章。
Matthew chapter 26.
我们读四十到四十三节。
We read verse 40 to verse 43. Verse 40. Then he came to the disciples and found them sleeping, and said to Peter, What, could you not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray, lest you enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. Again a second time he went away and prayed, saying, O my Father, if this cup cannot pass away from me, unless I drink it, your will be done. 43. And he came and found them asleep again, for their eyes were heavy.
这是我们很熟悉的一个克西马尼园的一个情景。
This is a very familiar scenario that we know of the Garden of Gethsemane.
主耶稣是这时候其实是最忧伤、最痛苦、几乎忧伤到要死的这种地步的情形。
This is a state where the Lord Jesus was most sorrowful unto the point of death.
哦，他带着最爱的门徒哈、哦，比哈、哦、他们去一起祷告，可是这些最爱的门徒却睡着了。
He brought along his most beloved disciples to pray together, and yet they were all sleeping.
They were unable to be vigilant
with Jesus.
不能够哈跟耶稣一同来哈体会耶稣的忧伤，体会耶稣的痛苦。他们没办法跟耶稣一起来体会。
They were unable to empathize with the Lord Jesus of his sorrow and of his distress.
这时，其实你看前面，主耶稣是非常痛苦，也是非常害怕的。圣经说，耶稣突然间惊恐起来，惊恐啊，不是害怕。圣经是用惊恐来表达，很害怕，很害怕。
If you read the passage before this, you will realize that the Lord Jesus was indeed most sorrowful and distressful, and even in great fear.
但回头一看
，When you turn back,
带着的门徒在那边睡觉。
The disciples that he brought along were sleeping.
所以主耶稣更显示出主耶稣那时的心情更痛苦，甚至更加的孤独。更加的寂寞。
And this must be heartbreaking for the Lord Jesus, and he was only most lonely.
主耶稣就勉励他们。
The Lord Jesus encouraged them.
你们不能够同我警醒片时吗？就是这一个时刻，这个重要时刻，这一段时间，难道不能够警醒吗？这个时刻。
Could you not watch with me at least this 1 hour, this critical hour?
总要警醒祷告。
And yet watch and pray.
免得入了迷惑。
Lest you enter into temptation.
十字架道路的第八个步就是不入迷惑。
The eighth don't on the way of the cross is do not enter into temptation.
这是一个受迷惑的世代。
But this is a generation which is highly tempted.
因为这世代已经有许多人进入了迷惑，已经进入了进去了。
Because this generation of ours have already entered into temptation.
所以这个世代是一个受迷惑的世代。
Therefore, this is a generation which is greatly tempted.
所以活在这个世代的世人，都是哈、哦、进入了迷惑啊，都是受迷惑的世人，甚至进入迷惑的世人。
Therefore, all people who live in this generation, we are all living in deception and amidst temptation.
是什么事、什么人、什么东西在迷惑我们呢？
What are the circumstances, things, and people who are deceiving us and tempting us?
迷惑的真正的源头在哪里？
And where is this source of temptation?
我们来看主耶稣给我们的答案。
We look at what Jesus answered.
你说世界很多迷惑啦，钱啦，这些荣华富贵啦，地位啦，衣服啦，什么名牌啦，当然这些都是迷惑，种种的很多迷惑。
Now you claim that all this money and all these luxury things, all these branded goods are all temptation.
但真正迷惑的源头是什么？知道吗
？What is the source of these temptations?
主耶稣给我们答案。
Let Jesus answer this for us.
请看启示录十二章。
Return to Revelation chapter 12.
启示录十二章
Revelation chapter 12.
我们读第九节。
We read verse 9. Verse 9. So the great dragon was cast out, that serpent of old called the devil and Satan, who deceives the whole world. He was cast to the earth, and the angels were cast out with him.
看到吗？
Do you see?
迷惑的源头在哪里？
Where is the source of temptation?
主耶稣告诉我们，迷惑我们的源头，那个源头啊，
the very
就在灵界里面。
The very source of this temptation and deception is in the spiritual realm.
物质世界的引诱只是用来迷惑我们的工具，只是一种工具，它不是源头来的。
And all this ensnarement, all these temptations in the materialistic world is only a tool, it is not the source.
主耶稣说，真正迷惑我们的那个源头啊，就是那条大龙，那个红龙。
Now the Lord Jesus tells us that this source of temptation is by this great dragon.
那也叫做蛊蛇。
Which is also called a serpent of old.
也叫做魔鬼。
Also the devil.
又叫做撒旦。
And Satan.
他是迷惑普天下。
He is the one who deceives the whole world.
耶稣讲得很清楚了，他不只是迷惑你，迷惑我，他是迷惑普天下的，全世界全天下，他是做去迷惑的。
The Lord Jesus spoke succinctly that this is the one who deceives the whole world.
迷惑是这个魔鬼这条龙的最大的工作。他最紧要的工作，最看重的工作，最紧张的工作，就是不断的迷惑，迷惑，不断的迷惑。
This deception is the work that has been greatly emphasized and also most critical to Satan.
再看，那主耶稣为什么要捆绑这条大红龙呢？
But why did the Lord Jesus have to bind this great dragon down?
那个答案也是迷惑。
The answer was because of deception.
请看这个二十章。
We look at verse chapter 20.
启示录二十章。
Revelation chapter 20,
一到三节
verse 1 to verse 3.
这里第二节说，主耶稣抓住那龙，就是蛊蛇，又叫魔鬼，也叫撒旦，把他捆绑一千年。
Verse 2, the Lord Jesus had laid hold of the dragon and bound him for 1,000 years.
请注意，为什么要把他捆绑呢？
Why was he bound for 1,000 years?
第三节
verse 3,
忍在无底坑里，将无底坑关闭，用印封上，目的是使他不得再迷惑列国。目的不要让他再迷惑列国。
It is done so that he should deceive the nations no more.
前面那个十二章九节，耶稣的强调说他是迷惑天下的。
In chapter 12, verse 9, the Lord Jesus stressed that he was the one who deceives the whole world.
一直到二十章的时候，主耶稣也告诉，也继续的说，我绑他，我为什么要捆绑他？就是因为他迷惑，不要让他迷惑。
And chapter 20 tells us why the Lord Jesus had to bind this dragon with great chain. That's in order for him not to deceive.
除了迷惑还是迷惑，是吗？
And his work is only to deceive and deceive.
好，到他放出来一千年完了，过后他一千年放出来，你看他做什么？第一件事情做什么？
And after this 1,000 years of his captivity, what will he do first?
放出来了还是做迷惑的工作。
After he was being released, he will do the work of deception.
看第七节跟第八节。
We read verse 7 to verse 8.
那一千年完了，撒旦必从监牢里面放出来，出来要迷惑地上四方的列国呀！出来一出来就继续去迷惑了，就去迷惑了。
After this thousand of years of imprisonment, Satan will be released to deceive all nations.
对，我们看到这几节圣经是，所以说他是迷惑的。第二，他还是迷惑的。第三，他仍然是迷惑的。
Now we have read so many verses, and we can already understand how the Lord Jesus was stressing that his work is to deceive, deceive, and deceive.
所以今天这个世界的繁华啊、虚荣啊、钱财啊、美色，通通不过是撒旦用来迷惑我们的工具，那个不是源头。
And therefore,
源头是撒旦，是那条红龙。
All the prosperity, splendor, and the great things of this world are only temptation in the materialistic world, but its very source is only Satan, this great dragon.
传道的意思说，你要真正不受迷惑，要对付迷惑，你就要对付那条龙，对付那条蛇，对付那个魔鬼。
What I'm trying
to 还是真正的解决迷惑的问题呀。
What I'm trying to stress to you is that the way to truly resolve this problem or this temptation of deception, you ought to defeat the devil, this great Satan, this great dragon, but not on this materialistic
thing. 你对付世界的东西、物质的东西，你对付了多少？你能够反抗了多少？
How much can you do with all these materialistic things in this world?
因为不只是钱啊，还有名利啊。
Not just the money, but also your fame.
这里面还有骄傲啊。
Your pride.
骄傲了还有嫉妒啊。
Your jealousy.
而且还有很多你没完没了的东西太多了啦。
There are so many things that you'll be tempted. You can't even count.
要对付的是那个源头啊。
But you have to counter the source of this temptation.
所以有句话说，要怎么对付魔鬼呢？有一种句话最简单、最直接、最有功效的话来讲。
If you have to summarize in one word or in one phrase, the best way to counter Satan.
对付魔鬼可以讲三天三夜的方法啦。
You can speak three days and three nights about the ways to counter the devil.
可以讲一大篇的道理来对付他了。
You can talk about so many sermons to counter the devil.
就用一句话来讲就好了。
But if you have to summarize in one phrase,
简单说，对付魔鬼就是他要我做的，我偏偏就不要做呀。
Simply put, whatever Satan wants me to do, I will not do.
他不要我做的，我偏偏就做啊，做给他看。
Whatever Satan does not want me to do, I will definitely do it.
这样听明白吗？
Do you understand it?
魔鬼要我做的，我偏偏不做。他要我骂我的父母，我不骂。他要我离开我的神，我不做。他要我怎么样骄傲，我不骄傲。
Things.
他要我做的，我就不做就对了，我不做。
Things that the devil wants me to do to curse my parents and to depart from my God, I will not do that.
他不要我做的，我偏偏就做给他看。
Things that he does not want me to do, I will surely do it to his face.
他不要我敬拜神，我就去敬拜神啊，怎么样？
He does not want me to worship the true God, I will worship.
他不要我祷告，我就祷告，我就跪下来祷告啊，怎么样？
He does not want me to pray, I will pray right in his face.
我们继续来看这个十字架道路上的第九个步。
We continue to read or to learn on the ninth don't on the way of the cross.
就是不改变的爱。
This
不改变爱。
The love that does not change.
我们都有爱的。
We all have love.
只是我们的爱很快改变，会改变，甚至很快改变。
But our love is tends to change so often.
那十字架的道路上，十字架的爱就是不改变的爱，不改变主耶稣的爱。
But this love that we have on the way of the cross is the love of Jesus that never changes.
我们来看亚福音书十三章。
We turn to the Gospel of John chapter 13.
亚福音书十三章。
John chapter 13.
我们读第一节。
Verse 1.Verse 1. Now before the feast of the Passover, when Jesus knew that his hour had come, that he should depart from this world to the Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end.
这也是我们熟悉洗脚里的 这一篇章节。
This is a sermon about feet washing, and we are familiar with
it. 这里我们看到主耶稣用爱我们，爱到底的爱来爱我们。
The Lord Jesus Christ here we can see is loving us with the love of loving us to the end.
主耶稣既然知道世间属自己的人，就爱他们到底。既然爱世间属自己的人，就爱他们到底。主耶稣是用爱到底的爱来爱我们。
And this is the love with which he will love us to the end. Having loved his own who were in this world, these are all the people of his own.
那爱到底的爱就是不改变的爱了。
And this love to the end is one which does not change.
我们不是没有爱。
Not that we do not have love.
只是我们的爱没有爱到底。
It's just that our love never lasted to the end.
爱你今天，爱你明天，爱你十年，在二十年，我们的爱就不爱下去了，就不能再爱，就不想再爱下去了。
I love you today. I love you next year. I love you in another year to come. But I will not continue loving you.
理由很多了。
There's so many reasons.
因为你漂亮了，因为你老了，因为你没有钱了，因为你破事业了，因为你脾气不好了，因为你这个了，因为你那个了，理由太多了，我不想再爱下去了。
You're no longer pretty. You have gone old, and you have lost your business. You have gone bankrupt. There's so many reasons I will not love you anymore.
你就是没有用爱到底的爱来爱对方了，没有了。
You have not loved each other with a love to the end.
没有用爱到底的爱来爱你的先生，来爱你的妻子，那你的爱就会改变，很快会改变。
If you do not love your partner with this love that never changes, your love will be soon to change.
主耶稣就是用爱到底的爱来替门徒洗脚的。
And it is with this love with which the Lord Jesus will love to the end, he washed their feet.
就是用特别的爱，用特别的爱给特别的你，用特别的爱来给特别的你。
And this is the special love that he loved you especially.
真的是这主耶稣这个爱不是一般上的爱来的，是特别的爱来的。
And
用爱到底的爱，是特别的爱来爱我们的。给特别的你。
This love with which he will love us to the end is a very special one. It is nothing ordinary.
我们本来是没有特别的。
We are not ordinary.
我们跟世人一模一样，是泥土的，是罪人来的。
We are just like everyone else. We are sinners and we are made of.
为什么我们成为特别，在神面前成为特别
？But how are we established to be special before God's eyes?
这里耶稣自己讲啊。
Jesus said himself.
因为我们现在是属于他的呀。
Now we all belong to him.
看到吗？
Do you see it?
爱世间属自己的人，因为我们现在变成是不是世界的人，我们现在是属耶稣的人。
We are no longer part of this world or belong to this world. We all belong to Jesus.
那是跟世人不一样的，跟世人很特别的，分别出来了的，所以我们变成是特别的。
That has sufficiently separated us from the part of this world. We are special.
什么时候哈我们成为主耶稣啊自己的人呢？
Since when did we,
属耶稣自己的人呢
？Since when were we owned by the Lord Jesus？ 啊，
一般人都不属于耶稣的啦。
People do were not owned by the Lord Jesus。
所以主耶稣没有给他们这种特别的爱，这种爱到底的爱。
They who are not who do not belong to Jesus do not have this love until the end。
什么时候我们成为主的人
？But when are we owned by Jesus？
就是我们洗礼，罪被主宝血洗除的时候。
That's when our sins have been washed away by baptism.
就在那一刻，那个时候，我们真正成为属主的人，整个都是属于耶稣的。
From that moment on, we have become a part of Jesus. We belong to Jesus.
那我们属于主耶稣的时候，属于主耶稣的时候，主耶稣就用特别的爱，爱到底的爱来爱我们了。
When we belong to Jesus, here it says that he will love his own who are in this world until the very end.
所以那些不接受洗礼的人，我们不能够给他行洗脚礼的，知道吗？
And they who do not accept baptism, they will not have feet washing.
因为洗脚礼是特别的爱的，主耶稣特别的爱给他的，才有资格才配接受这个洗脚礼的，特别的人，特别的爱。
Because those who are qualified to receive this sacrament of feet washing are those who have been given a special love from the Lord Jesus.
所以不要自以为聪明啊，传道没关系的，他还没有洗礼，他先洗脚礼没关系的，反正他多几天呢，他多下个月就洗礼了啊，先洗脚礼也可以了，你不要乱来啊。他不是属主的，他就没有资格接受主耶稣的洗脚礼，主耶稣也不会给他洗脚。
Therefore, you have to understand that you never to jumble up the sequence of getting baptized first before you have to go for feet washing, because this feet washing is only meant for those who are already owned by Jesus.
第一题就像我们证明，就像我们说清楚了，爱自己的人哈，既然爱世间属基人，就爱他们到底，就跟他们洗脚呀。
Verse 1 already tells us that
是他们与主有份呢。
The Lord Jesus having loved his own, and only then he washed their feet, and so that they will have a part with Jesus.
感谢我们主耶稣基督，我们的救主。
We thank the Lord Jesus, our Savior.
他用特别的爱来爱我们。
That he loved us with this special love.
就是用特爱到底的爱来爱我们。
This is a special love with which he loved us to the end.
这爱到底的爱原来就是不改变的爱，爱你到底，你无论怎样，我都是爱你到底，我都是不改变的。
This love to the end is one which is an eternal love, and he will never change.
那十字架道路的第九个不就是不改变爱，不改变我们的爱。
Therefore, the ninth don't on the way of the cross is this love that does not change.
你对神的爱改变了吗？
Has your love towards God changed?
你以前爱神，现在还爱吗？
In the past, you loved God so much, and do you still love?
最后一个，
the last don't.
十架道路的第十个不，
the tenth don't on the way of the cross.
就是不否认自己的身份，
is do not disown your identity.
我们看马太福音书二十六章，
return to the Gospel of Matthew chapter 26.
马太福音书二十六章，
Matthew chapter 26,
62到66。
Verse 62 to 66.
62节。
62. And the high priest arose and said to him, Do you answer nothing? What is it that this man testify against you? 63. But Jesus kept silent, and the high priest answered and said to him, I put you under oath by the living God. Tell us if you are the Christ, the Son of God. Jesus said to him, It is as you said. Nevertheless, I say to you, hereafter you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the power, coming on the clouds of heaven. 65. The high priest tore his clothes, saying, "He has spoken blasphemy. What further need do we have to have a witness?"
Okay, okay. 当大祭司哈指着主耶稣说，对耶稣说，我指着永生神叫你起誓，你是不是神的儿子？是不是神的儿子？基督是不是？
And now the high priest said to him, with his finger pointing at him, "That do you answer nothing? Are you the Son of God?"
64节，耶稣对他说，你说的是。
64, Jesus said to him, It is as you said.
主耶稣在这个时刻，在任何时刻，他都没有否认自己的身份。
At any moment or in any circumstance, the Lord Jesus never denied his identity.
如果你聪明一点，你最好就不要回答这个问题。
If you are any smarter, you will not answer this question.
因为他们就是要抓你一把，他们大祭司问你这个问题，叫你起誓，就是要抓你的把柄，就是要告你的，就要定你死罪的。
And now the high priest was trying to set a trap for Jesus because he was putting him under an oath.
你说你是神的儿子基督，你就被就不用再审了，不用再找证人了，直接就判你有罪了。
Now, if you utter these words that you are the Son of God, and this, there will be no need for any trials, so, and you are convicted.
所以当耶稣说是我就是的时候，你说的是的时候，大祭司就撕开衣服说不用再审了。他说健忘的话了，他羞辱神了，他怎么样怎么样怎么样了，就。
Now this is the reason why as soon as the Lord Jesus agreed to this statement, the high priest tore his clothes and said that he has spoken blasphemy. There's no need to even have even more witnesses.
开始吐口水在他脸上了，打他了。
Now they spat on him and they beat him up and they mocked him.
平时你承认你的身份，那 OK 的。
On the usual times, if you admit this, it is fine.
但是在这种情况当中，你一承认你的身份，你会死的，你会受伤的。你会付出代价的，你会变成一无所有的。请问你要不要承认你的身份？还是假装不知道，假装听不到？
This was a treacherous time for him to even think of admitting this, and or would you rather pretend as though you do not understand?
聪明人就说我假装听不到了，我不回答了。
The smart people will say that I do not understand the question. I will not answer.
逃过一劫啊，逃过这个灾难了，是吧？逃过这个试探，是吗？
Now you are so smart and you have evaded this temptation.
你要逃避，难道主耶稣不会逃避吗？
Would you think that the Lord Jesus was not smart?
主耶稣是没有逃避的，在十字架前的第十个不就是不否认自己的身份，我就是神的儿子，我就是基督。
The Lord Jesus made no attempt to run away from this temptation that in the, on the 10th don't on the way of the cross, that he does not deny his identity on the way of the cross.
你在这个紧要关头，这个试探关头，你会不会有勇气来承认呢？还是否认你的身份呢？
Very dangerous and critical time. Would you rather deny and disown your own identity?
我们会承认我们是神的儿女，这个是绝对没问题。我们是神的儿女，这绝对没有问题。
It seems easy for us, and there's no problem for us to admit that we are the children of God.
但是我们会不会承认我们是真耶稣教会？我们会承认吗？
But would you admit that you are the member of the true Jesus Church?
特别是真教会被攻击的时候、被讥笑的时候、被对付的时候，那段时间被践踏的时候。你会承认真耶稣教会吗？
Most especially in the times when the true Jesus Church has been slandered, attacked, and hurt, would you still admit readily that you are the member of the true Jesus Church?
你承认耶稣，但是你却不承认耶稣的妻子、耶稣的心腹，那不是很怪的吗？
Now you acknowledge Jesus, but you do not acknowledge the bride of the Lord Jesus, the church.
你承认主耶稣，却不承认主耶稣的身体就是教会。你不承认这个教会，但是你说我承认主耶稣，你不承认主耶稣的身体，那不是很奇怪的事吗？
Now you acknowledge Jesus, but you do not acknowledge the body of Jesus, this church, and wouldn't that be very strange?
所以你承认主耶稣，你一定要承认主耶稣的教会。
Therefore, if you acknowledge Jesus, you must acknowledge his church.
当真教会受攻击、受逼迫、会受辱骂的时候，这个时候，我们就不否认我们是真耶稣教会。
When a true church has been attacked and also humiliated, this is a time where you do not deny that you are a member of the true church.
这是主耶稣很清楚的、很严重的警告我们、提醒我们，不可否认你的身份。
This has been a very clear instruction and command from the Lord Jesus that we do not disown our identity.
请看马太福音书第十章。
Return to Gospel Matthew chapter 10.
32-33节。
Verse 32-33.
凡在人面前认我的。我在我天上父的面前也必认他。
Whoever confesses me before man, him I will confess before my Father in heaven.
凡在人面前不承认我的，我在我天上父的面前我也不承认他。
Whoever denies me before man, him I will also deny before my Father in heaven.
耶稣讲的很清楚了。
It is a very clear statement.
哦，原来十字架的最后的第十个不就是你不否认自己的身份，千万不可否认。
Now,
不能否认。
The tenth don't on the way of the cross being very importantly, we do not deny our identity.
免得在天上的时候，神也不，主耶稣也不承认我。
Lest in heaven, the Lord Jesus will deny also us.
这个刚才我们唱那首诗歌说，我们是耶稣的门徒，就是耶稣的学生。
As we sang the hymn just now, Blessed Jesus, our Savior, we are his disciple, we are his student.
就是学习耶稣的人。
We are also one who learns and emulates Jesus.
我们就学习主耶稣十架道路的十步，我们把学好它。
Let's all learn properly all these 10 don'ts on the way of the cross.
荣耀真神。
We give glory to God.
Amen.
Amen.
我们唱诗110首。
To sing hymn 110. Thank the Lord Jesus for Emmanuel, for He is with us.
啊，那明天是安息圣日。
Tomorrow is the Holy Sabbath.
啊，我们一整天都有机会啊，敬拜侍奉。
We dedicate the entire day for worship and service.
我们大家准备一颗心哈，来献给主，也给自己。
Let's prepare our hearts to offer to God and to ourselves.
啊，一整天都沐浴，从今天晚上开始到明天的一整天。都沐浴在神的话语当中，神的道理当中。
That we allow ourselves from tonight on to immerse ourselves in the love and the words of God.
沐浴在神的话语中，就是沐浴在神的生命当中，圣洁的生命当中。
To bathe and to immerse in the words of God is to bathe and immerse in the holiness and the word of God.
一起祷告。
Let's pray.
奉主耶稣圣名祷告，哈利路亚！感谢赞美主耶稣。Thank you.
Thank you.
感谢主耶稣，阿门。
任凭他随意引导，我心中毫无畏惧。无论何望不出远远，随主脚中一路行。任凭他随意引导，我心中毫无畏惧。无论何望不出远远，随主脚中一路行。
感谢主耶稣，阿们。感谢主耶稣祝福带领我们的聚会。
Thank the Lord Jesus for His blessings and guidance throughout the service.
聚会到这里结束。
Our service concludes here.
大家起立互道平安。
May all rise to greet.
哈利路亚。
哈利路亚。
大家平安，明天见呢。
Peace be with you. See you tomorrow.